Okay, welcome to the day two of the Six Sigma White Belt training program. And yesterday we understood the fundamentals like Motorola introduced the Six Sigma in 1987. They named it as Six Sigma methodology. That time it contained four phases and later General Electric. They converted that four phase methodology into five phase methodology. Bill Smith is called the father of Six Sigma. And then we understood quality is driven by three factors: customer requirement, process requirement, employee requirement. If you can take care of these three requirements, then quality can happen for sure. And we also understood Lean Six Sigma is a strategy which can help you improve the quality of your products. At the same time, your product can be priced at a competitive price. At the same time, you can deliver faster. And Six Sigma is a customer-centric approach, data-driven approach, process-centric approach, right? And all these things we have understood. And today's goal is, I will help all of you understand, dive deeper into statistics, right? We will try to understand the statistical meaning of statistics. Not only that, we will also see a case study how the Six Sigma approach, the statistical way of problem solving, can help in solving our business problem, be it whatever product, whatever service you are dealing with in your current business. You can use all the learnings now you are going to learn today in your current business also. So let us proceed. Right. So there is another philosophy coming to all of you. Quality is a function of two things. One is called capability. Another one is called stability. So the stability is nothing but, I touched it yesterday, the statistical control. Whether your process outputs are really great or not, that is one side. If the process outputs are great, then you consider it capable. You consider it capability. But if the process outputs are consistent, then we are going to call it stable. Your processes are stable. If you ask me which is more important, whether the capability or the stability, I will say stability is very important, because the preference should be achieving the stability. If the stability is achieved, and definitely capability can be improved. Because the fundamental definition of quality is meeting customers' requirement consistently. I have divided that statement into two parts. The first part is meeting customers' requirement. This is called process capability. This is called process capability. And another thing, doing it so consistently, because always you are producing products in multiple units, 1,000 units a batch, 10,000 units a batch, and some of you might even produce more. So every output you produce should have the desired quality. And so that is called the stability. Statistical control you need to achieve. Very, very important. Once the statistical control is achieved, then it can be improved. I gave an example yesterday. Like when you are teaching to a set of students, teacher should have control over the students. Then only your lecture can transform the student. The students are not in your control. The world best teacher trains you, and it is not going to produce the desired outcome. But however, if the students are in your control, they are paying proper attention, then it will make a lot of sense, a professor or a trainer delivering a beautiful lecture. Same way, all your improvement efforts will produce the result only when your business processes are in statistical control. And that is why you need to plot control chart. Control chart can simply tell you whether your processes are in statistical control or not. If the points are outside the control limit, you can definitely understand your process is getting disturbed by an external force, right? We call it special cause. First duty is fix the special cause. Then the next duty is improve the process. Fixing the special cause simply ensures you get all the points inside the control limit. Improving the process further ensures you push your control limits further inside towards the center, right? Without getting all the points inside the control limit, there is no point trying to push the control limit further inside. Then there will be more rejections. You should not do that, right? So this is what medical doctors are also doing. They will operate the patient only if the patient's body condition is stable. The BP level, sugar level, and everything needs to normalize, stabilize. If that stabilizes, then doing the operation will make a lot of sense. Your operation can be success and patient can also survive. If you don't understand the logic, if you operate a patient when he is having a higher BP, then your operation is successful, but patient will be dead. So you should not do that mistake. Always make sure the process achieves statistical control before trying to improve it further. Hope it was made clear to all of you, right? And every slide, if you have any question, you need to ask me then and there, right? And now I'm showing a slide now. I hope you can identify what it is. This is called a ring of fire. I hope all of you know what is ring of fire, right? So the outside of the ring frame is burning. And now, what I want is, I want all of you to jump inside the ring of fire one by one. At the same time, you need to come out safely on the other side. The inside area is circular. Hope all of you agree with me. And circle means there are infinite number of points. Now tell me all of you, which point will you consider to make your jump? Come on, you need to answer now.
Center.
Oh, beautiful. Chandramouli says center. Hope everybody is agreeing with Chandramouli. If you have any other different opinion, you can share. Otherwise, I will assume everybody agrees to Chandramouli's answer. Center. This is called central tendency. This is called what? Central tendency. Anytime, anything we are doing, we will try to execute around the central tendency only. And Chandramouli, can you also please explain, why did you choose the center? What is the advantage there?
Because from center, all the distance to the edge is same. So if you see all 360 degree,
yes,
from center point, if you measure everywhere, it is same.
Very good. Beautiful answer. Sir, center is the point which is, one is at equal distance. Not only that, most important, that is, the point is far away from the outer edge, isn't it? That is the point which is far away from the outer edge. Because on the outside, you have the flame. You have the burning temperature. So you don't want to be hit by the temperature. So you want it to be safer. And that is why you have chosen the center. Simple reason is, in plain English, the risk is very low. That is why making all of you to execute your jump through the center. All right. And now imagine you have made your jump beautifully. You have jumped exactly through the center and then you came out on the other side. But will you be able to jump continuously on the same point? Smaller point is difficult. So I'm going to give you an area. Some area, additional allowance. So now I have given a small circular area. Earlier you made one jump. And now here also you can make one jump. But now I want all of you to make 10 jumps, one after the other, within 10 minutes. Now tell me, can all of you will be able to make all your 10 jumps successfully through the circle?
No.
Looks difficult, challenging. That means you are capable. You are definitely capable. You already executed it beautifully. One jump was successful. your capability is clear. But when I increase the number of jumps to 10, that too in 10 minutes, then, you know, you are able to understand some of your jumps are going to be outside the circle. Now you will start feeling the temperature. And now I want you to jump more. Now you need to jump 100 times. You need to jump 100 times and that too in 30 minutes. Now definitely you will have much more jumps in the orange zone. That means now your skin will be cut by the temperature. Now what is happening here? You are capable, but you are not able to maintain it.
Table.
Yes, yes, Yalam. Yeah, you want to share something. Come on. Okay, all right. So, yes, you want to add anything here?
We are capable, but stability is decreasing.
Exactly, exactly. So we are capable of jumping it. We made it. Our trial runs are good. In company, our trial runs are good. My PPAP is good. My initial production, you know, pilot run is good. But when I want to produce more, that time only problem is coming. Am I correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Initial steady 100 units we are able to make without any problem. All 100 are beautiful. But what happened when I want to produce 1,000, when I want to produce 10,000, and now a lot of defectives are coming? That is why, you know, consistency is also important. Stability is also important. And now when you start coming away from the center, if you are not in the white circle, if you come to yellow or if you come to orange or if you come further beyond, your risk keeps on increasing. Your tendency to move away from the center is called deviation. Statistically, we call it variation. This variation, when it is more, the risk will be more. Hope all of you are able to understand what I'm talking. One is central tendency. Central tendency is the center point where the risk is minimum. However, when the number of execution increases, for example, the customer demand increases, seeing your capability, customer has increased his demand. Give me 10,000 units every day. Give me 10,000 units every day. And now what happened? Your capability is going down. You started making your jumps away from the center. This is called variation. So in any business process also, there will be a central tendency. There will be a variation. You need to know both. What is central tendency? The low risk point. The low risk point, what it is. And then what is the actual risk? And you can measure both when you know the meaning of average and standard deviation. I made a video on both. What is the meaning of the term mean? Average means what? Standard deviation means what? How it is helpful? And we'll see today also. So the mean or average will let you understand the central tendency of your process. The standard deviation will let you understand the amount of variation or the amount of risk you have in your process. All right. So this is the formula for